Scion of Udugazi. 5-mana 4/4 populate. Far Away is really strong as well. 4-mana 4/2. Regenerate. Flux Charger. A lot of these cards are pretty strong in this pack. Is it Guildgate? I can't believe we first picked a Pilfered Plains last time. Okay, so I think Scion of Udugazi is a little stronger than Far Away, except Far Away is like much easier to cast in our deck. It's still unclear whether we're going to splash white. We have all these lands, but you know, I'd like to be Grixis if possible. Far Away is just super busted. I mean, 5-mana, bounce one thing, sack another thing. It's really strong, so we want to take it. Xur'Ta Ancient. It's not really the deck for it. We can take a Gatekeepers and splash green. Just play all these gates, and I just have like all our lands coming to play tapped. Weapon Surge. We're playing a really defensive deck. Fatal Fumes. Target creature gets -4/-2. This card seems okay. It's not the best, but it's on color-ish and kills things. And it, I mean, we can table the Gatekeepers. The Gatekeepers tabled the last time around, so I don't really see another pick here. Well, I mean, there's other kinds of wild picks, but that seems like the strongest one for us. Here's another Maze Glider if we want four of those cards. I wouldn't mind four. It seems really only weak to, like, Maze Behemoth. I haven't seen very many cards that, like, have five power. There's a Species Gorger and, like, Maze Behemoth, but I'm down to just rock four of these, honestly. Like, we don't have any bombs up top, so just four 6-mana 3/5 flyers, and they give our other stuff flying. Not that that really matters, but I'm okay with just having a bunch of these. I really like it, actually. Guildgate, almost certainly. Although, the Phantasm's sweet. We don't have a lot of 2-drops. I mean, we do, but it's going to be hard to actually cast these things on 2 or even 3. But we've got all these Gatekeepers, and here's actually an on-color gate, because it doesn't look like we're necessarily going to play any white cards. We don't have a single white card we want to play. We could easily play one if we grabbed one. Like the white Gatekeeper, for example, is really strong. 3 and a white. 2/4, make a 2/2. It's it would be a pretty good pickup, actually. Okay, let's take a look at this pack. 3-mana, whenever creature control the kind of does combat damage, draw a card. Not at all for us. Here's a Windrake. Let's just take a Rakdos Guildgate, make our mana better, and turn on our Gatekeepers a little bit more. It's just not really a reason for anything else, in my opinion. I just don't care for Windrake. We've got these 4 Maze Gliders, which are just going to rule the skies, so I don't think we need it. We could take these Gatekeepers. They're not super strong, though. Until end of turn, whenever you control creature you control gain, when this creature dies, it deals 2 damage to a creature and opponent controls. This card might be good. I don't know if we want 3 of these. Wear, tear, don't care for that. Put up 4 cards of your library in the graveyard, return from the graveyard to the battlefield. Not in love with this. It's good with our Maze Gliders, I guess. And we could splash with a Golgari Guildgate. I don't really like it. Although I don't really like Showstopper either. We can take Showstopper, I guess. I choked on that one. I really don't know. It's my very first time doing this, so it's gonna be, and maybe my last, because by the time I get back from Portland this weekend, I think they may have the full setup, which is something I would rather do. Target creature gets +1, gains double strike, all creatures able to block do. Oh wow, that's really strong with this. I kind of want it 6-mana. I kind of want to take it. Like, we don't need another Dimir Cluestone. We have 2. And it's just, like, insane with Nivik Cyclops. If we pay 6 mana, can just basically kill their team. Plus 1. It'd be a 5/5 double striker, okay. So here we have a Cyclops, a Guildgate, and a Giant. I like Giant, but we already have 4/6 drops. I don't think we need any more. I like Cyclops more because we just picked up this double thing. Guildgate, we have, what, 2 green cards? I think I'd rather take the Guildgate here because I don't want to play any of these green-white lands. So 3 of these Guildgates don't count. And it's probably our last Guildgate that we need. We could play another Pilfered Plans. I don't mind just drawing cards. Yeah, we should be able to, it doesn't seem like we're going to get juked in the ground at all, so this seems pretty strong. Just don't like Maze Rusher that much. 6 mana, 6/3, haste is not really what our deck's looking for, in my opinion. I'll play 2 of these Gatekeepers. Gaining 7 life is a lot, and we're going to have 2 gates often. And at this point, Species Gorger looks pretty good as, a bomb to just, gain 7 life every turn or whatever. So, in green, we would maybe play that. I don't think we'd play Hired Torturer. We have barely any black cards, huh? So our mana's actually going to be really good. Should be pretty good relative to, playing an absurd 5-color deck. So, yeah, I ended up not liking Morgue Burst very much. And it looks like the table didn't either, as these are coming around super late. Although, this is a card that you'd, maybe want one of, I think. I don't think you'd ever want to play a bunch because it's really situational. But I can imagine it being really strong. It kills their thing and gets you your best creature back. But that's a pretty specific situation. Let's play all the Gatekeepers. Maze Gliders. I like a Warped Physique. These crawlers are maybes. I mean, they're pro green, so it seems like something we don't necessarily want in the main. We could play Showstopper. I like Armed Dangerous because of how it interacts with Nivek Cyclops. Breaking Entering and Far Away are obviously really good. I like Fatal Fumes. I don't like Showstopper that much. That was maybe a wasted pick. Maybe it's good, I don't know. It's just so situational. Let's try it out. Well, we'll see. Actually, I don't like it because I want to play some of these glue stones, probably. Probably, and then I want to play lots of lands. Selesnya. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, is that it? Well, we need to play some of these white clue stones, or white guild gates, even though we're not going to play white cards, because we have 5 of these, and I'd like to draw 2 of these. 6 seems like we're have a good chance of drawing them. So later on, we'll cut some basics in our mana to put in these and figure that out. I like Dimir Clue Stones a bit. They get us to 6 mana. They fix our mana a little bit. Dimir Clue Stones and the Pilfered Plans is pretty slow. I wonder if we're just going to be too slow. It's unclear. Let's sideboard these. Mind Static seems slow. Showstopper is real slow and situational. What if we just play a Dimir Clue Stone and then play 18 lands? Are we going to get flooded? Do we not have a late game? Are these Maze Gliders not a real late game? Who knows? We're going to find out. Alright, we're going to put in all of these. Add land. I kind of want at least one forest because we only have 2 green sources right now. By color. We may even need another forest. Black. We don't need very much black, actually. Barely any. So this Dimir Clue Stone could maybe be a Golgari Clue Stone, actually, potentially. Because we're going to be base blue anyway. Black, 2, 3, 4 black mana, and we have 1, 5. I guess we could try another black. Try red. We have 1, 2, 3. Really, our mana's not going to be very bad, huh? I missed that one for the black. 4. 1, 2, 3. There's not really a science to this. It's just like, I'm just putting in lands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8's a lot, but... And we don't even necessarily need it early. So our mana looks pretty good, actually. So I'm okay with adding, like, an extra forest, mountain, and swamp. And then we're gonna put in a couple of these. Just so that we have more gates. Because we have 5 gatekeepers and 5 gates currently. It sucks that we're gonna play lands that just come into play tapped. But we really need to hit these. So say that it's the 4th turn. We're likely to have drawn, like... 10-ish cards on average. 2 gates means we would need 8 gates in our deck on average to get there, but we're not necessarily needing to play these turn 4. So I kind of want to play 2 extra gates just because. I don't know whether we want to... Blue comes into play, tapped land. It's just complete random almost that I'm doing this. So now we have 7 gates, which is like I think enough to often be there. We've pilfered plans to draw. Maybe we're like so desperately needing to get there that we should play even more, but we're gonna figure that out in game 1. I don't want to play more than 7 just off top, but let's try it out. This is a pretty interesting deck, and I am interested to see what else people drafted, what kind of decks they're doing. So let's submit.